Here's another review from us.
Hit it, Opal.
Imagine being stranded in a blackout with nothing but your gear and a single box that can power your home, your tools, and even your island cabin. Well, that's exactly what we're testing today. The Bluetti Apex 300 paired with the B300K expansion battery plus the DC hub. Together, they promise to deliver flexible, scalable, off-grid backup power that punches far above its weight class. What do you say we tear into these boxes and have a look at what Bluetti has to offer?
We homestead on an off-grid island in northern BC, Canada. This Apex 300 will come in handy by providing additional power when our main solar battery banks are depleted. This is the Bluetti B300K expansion battery. It adds 2.7 kilowatts of battery storage to the Apex 300. Now let's unpack this power station and see what it does.
One thing I'll say about Bluetti as a company is they absolutely have the most robust protected packaging of any electronics I've ever bought in my entire life. Box within a box, strapped down, corners are protected. It's unbelievable the care that they take. There's some serious packaging. Look how thick the foam is. There's no way this is going to get damaged in transit. Wow, this is a good looking modular setup. We have 2.7 kilowatts here, 2.7 kilowatts here. Together we have 5.4 kilowatts of energy storage in this one compact little package. Everything about the Bluetti is first class. Look at these rubber protectors that go over these battery connectors here. They don't spare any expense. It's designed for longevity. So that goes in there like that. This goes in here like this. Everything just fits. It's all designed perfectly. You can lock it in position. Now it's secure. It will not come out. So let's focus on the panel for a minute. This is the front face of the Bluetti Apex 300. You have your 120 volt, 240 volt switch here. Very simple. You switch it down into 240 volts. And guess what? This means that 240 volts and 120 volts are available. You've got all your 120 volt outlets here, and you've got your 240 volt outlets over on this side. We've got a 30 amp outlet here, and we have a 50 amp 240 volt outlet here.
Conspicuously absent from the Apex 300 are any 12 volt charge ports to charge your electronic devices. Now this is by design because Bluetti has positioned the Apex 300 to provide power in off-grid scenarios like for say cabins and RVs, and also for whole home backup to provide uninterrupted power in the event of a grid failure. For those of you that are concerned that there is only one USB-A charge port on the front of the expansion battery, fear not. Look at this! This is the Bluetti DC Hub and it is an auto-switching 12 volt or 24 volt power delivery bank. It will run all your 12 volt or 24 volt power systems. It has two 15 watt USB-A sockets plus 200 watt USB-C sockets for a total of 200 watts for USB-C. It also has two barrel connectors plus two cigarette lighter type sockets, so this is a fully equipped DC power center to charge all your DC devices. But wait, there's more! I always wanted to say that. On the end here is an Anderson connector that will charge 12 volt batteries at 50 amps or 24 volt batteries at 25 amps. All in all, the versatility of this unit is very impressive, and because it pulls the power natively from the internal or expansion batteries, it eliminates any conversion loss you would otherwise expect by converting AC to DC prior to delivery.
You can power a forklift, you can power golf carts, you can power anything that uses an Anderson connector, your RV. You can charge your batteries with an Anderson connector as well, so you can actually use this Bluetti to charge your batteries for your boat or your side-by-side or whatever you have off-grid that needs a 12-volt or a 24-volt battery. So I'm out here in nature with the Bluetti Apex 300. I've got 400 watts of solar panels hooked up, and the solar panels are currently drawing 34 watts. It's because we have an overcast sky. I've seen it get as high as 40 watts today, but not much in terms of solar input. If you want to charge the Apex 300 with solar, you must have a nice bright sunny day and adequate solar panels. I'll get into that a little bit later. I also have a 1,000-watt heater drawing power from the Bluetti. It's drawing 992 watts. So it fluctuates a little bit. The Apex 300 can actually deliver 3,800 watts and it can deliver twice that in a surge situation. So for things like compressors and welders, equipment that has high capacitive startups, the 7.6 kilowatt surge on the Apex 300 is more than adequate to handle that.
Right now, I've got two heaters and an air compressor hooked up to the Bluetti. And you can see it has no problems with this load.
All right, now we're gonna check the Bluetti surge, see how that performs. The Bluetti is outputting 2,400 watts to power these two heaters. I'm gonna turn on the compressor. That'll take it to about 3,500 watts. Then I'll use the saw as a surge and see what happens.
3,500 watts. 5,200 watts.
No problem.
The Bluetti can handle this surge for about 10 seconds. And there's a little flashing clock on the display that indicates an active surge load.
Let's talk about expansion. The Apex 300 is the most versatile, expandable power station I've come across so far. On board, it has 2.7 kilowatts of energy storage. You can connect another six modules of 2.7 kilowatts if you're connecting B300Ks. If you're connecting B500Ks, you can connect another 30 kilowatts on top of the 2.7 kilowatts. That's huge. And if for every reason 30 kilowatts is not enough for you, don't worry, it's expandable even further. You can use the A1 hub, connect three Apex 300s with six each of the B300K expansions, each with 30 kilowatts, plus each of these has roughly 3 kilowatts, 2.7 kilowatts. You know what that means? You've got a 100 kilowatt system here. You don't have to buy it all at once. It'll grow with you. The point I'm trying to drive home here is this is the last system you will ever need. It is expandable, it can grow with you, and as the technology increases, I can only wait to see what other surprises Bluetti has coming up around the corner. Let's talk about charging the Apex 300 with solar, okay? Over on this side, we have two PV inputs. Each PV input has a 1200 watt maximum capacity at 60 volts maximum input, okay? That means all your panels together can't send more than 60 volts to the Apex 300. One curious thing about solar panels is that they output more voltage as the temperature drops. Therefore, it's best practice to maintain a 15 to 20% safety margin, meaning if your MPPT has a maximum rating of 60 volts, then you should keep the total voltage of your array at no higher than 50 volts. So how do you do that? You can set up your panels in a series parallel configuration to ensure that they don't output more than 50 volts. There are lots of videos to show you how to do this, and if you're interested and would like to know more, you can check out the link I'll put in the video description below.
So 2400 watts is great, but that only works with arrays of small low voltage panels. What if I have large format panels that output higher voltages?
This is the Bluetti SolarX 4K. If you have access to a whole bunch of panels, you can send up to 500 volts into the SolarX 4K. It'll step that down to 60 volts, but it'll charge the Apex 300 super fast. All the magic happens in this little box. It's a charge controller voltage converter, and it takes huge strings, converts it down into a safe voltage that the Apex 300 can utilize while maintaining the power throughput to charge the batteries quickly and safely. This thing is a game changer. This will take up to 500 volts of power. Now, why is that important? The thing about electricity is the higher the voltage, the lower the current. And the lower the current, the smaller the wire you can use. And the smaller the wire you can use, the way less money it costs to actually set this up, because copper is super expensive. You can take 4 kilowatts of solar power to charge 5.4 kilowatts of energy storage. And guess what? That takes less than an hour and a half. That cuts your time down massively.
The SolarX 4K is perfect for both off-grid and whole home backup situations where you can leverage your existing large-scale arrays to quickly charge up your Apex 300 and all of its expansion batteries. There are many ways to charge the Apex 300 solar power station. We've already discussed solar charging. Now let's talk about charging from the grid.
There's a couple of inputs. There's a 110 input that you can plug right into your outlet at home. That can get you up to 15 amps at 120 volts. That's roughly 1800 watts. That's not bad. That's a couple hours to charge the Bluetti. Bluetti has different cables available for purchase separately. You can get a 30 amp cable or a 50 amp cable. Either one will connect to this port and it'll charge a Bluetti in as little as 1 hour. Now, if you add battery expansion units, double that time. Bluetti's an hour, add one of these, add another hour. Add two of these, add 2 hours, and so on. But it's still very, very fast. The neat thing about the Bluetti is it has different charging modes here. You have a silent charging mode, which really, you can barely hear the fan. So you could easily have this thing charging in your bedroom and it would not keep you from sleeping. In turbo mode, it maximizes the power draw from whichever plug you're connected to. In this case, we're connected to the 120 volt power port and it's supplying almost 1400 watts of charging power. That's pretty impressive.
The Bluetti can be charged by a variety of methods and combinations. You can even charge your power station with its two MPPTs and the SolarX 4K at the same time for an impressive 6400 watts of charging power. That will charge your Apex 300 from 0 to 100% in only 25 minutes. Amazing!
Alright, let's take a look at how we connect the SolarX 4K to the Apex 300. All you need is this factory design cable, the positive and negative inputs, and the battery communication cable will go into the bottom of the SolarX 4K. This fancy cable here will go into the battery expansion port of either the Apex 300 itself or one of the expansion batteries. So let's get to work and I'll show you how this all fits together.
The SolarX 4K is well designed and includes intuitive graphics to eliminate any guesswork involved while connecting it. All connection points are labeled and the associated references in the manual are clear and concise. It has multiple ground points for various scenarios, so be sure to review the manual for your specific installation needs.
So this knockout is for that factory cable, and you just have to give it a couple twists like this to get the metal to fatigue and it pops right out. The cable comes right through the bottom like this, and you take the nut and you just screw it down like this. Communication goes into the CAN 1 port. Positive goes to positive, negative goes to negative. Very simple. Nice thing about this is they've tinned the wires at the factory in a nice square configuration. So they fit right into these ports perfectly. And they're very easy to tighten up with these screw lugs. The number one rule you want to observe when you're doing anything electrical is make sure your connections are tight. Connections have to be tight. Otherwise, you have the potential for arcing, and that is what causes fires. Okay, we're all connected except for the solar panels. They're going to connect here. Just doing this for demonstration purposes to show you how simple it is to connect this up. Okay, the plug is a D-shaped plug. It goes into this D-shaped socket right here. You put it in all the way till you hear a click. It can't come out. So that's it. That is all there is to connecting the SolarX 4K to the Bluetti. Once we have power coming in from our solar panels here, it will automatically power on. And after a few moments, it'll start sending power to charge the batteries. Very slick. I forgot to mention, Bluetti sends this OT connector. It receives a 10 gauge wire. This is for your ground. It's very, very important that you do this first, actually. This ground needs to be connected. I don't have any power here, so it's okay. Bluetti supplies the OT connector. It also supplies the grounding screw. What it doesn't supply is a grounding cable. And that makes sense because how would they know how much grounding cable you need? This number 10 cable needs to go back to your electrical box. needs to make sure that there is not a parallel path to ground. The ground has to go to your electrical box. We're dealing with high voltage here. This isn't hobby voltage. This is up to 500 volts. So you must take care to observe all the safety protocols and properly ground your system. If you're unsure at all, consult an electrician. Normally you would see a green wire come from here, out this knockout and over to your electrical panel. That's a safe way to do it. What we're going to test now is the UPS circuit, the uninterrupted power supply circuit. The Bluetti documentation said there's 0 ohm switching during a blackout. We currently have the Bluetti set up in pass-through mode. What pass-through mode means is the power comes through this cord, through the Bluetti, and out to the light, bypasses the batteries. Any additional power that doesn't power this light is used to charge the batteries. That's pretty cool. In the event of a power loss, the power is cut, so that means no more power is coming in through the AC input, and the power is automatically redirected to be drawn from the batteries through the AC ports here, okay? This works for 120 and 240, no problem. The 240 volt outlets are here, but we don't have anything plugged into the 240 volts. I just wanna see if this actually works as a 0 ohms uninterrupted power supply. 0 ohms means should be no flicker to the light. So let's see what happens when I kill the lights in the entire shop. Will this flicker? Now that was cool. Did you see that? There was absolutely no flicker. So that means that this is a true 0 ohms uninterrupted power supply. All your sensitive electronics like servers and routers and anything that has sensitive integrated circuits, if it's plugged in through the Apex and it's functioning as an uninterrupted power supply like it is in this configuration, all your data will be safe. That's peace of mind.
The Bluetti app lets you connect to all your Bluetti products and monitor them remotely over Wi-Fi or Bluetooth. It has a variety of handy tools and information, like how-to guides and FAQs. From within the app, you can choose the device you want to connect to, power on your AC or DC loads, and monitor battery reserves, set charging methods, and pretty much anything you can do by pushing buttons on the front panel itself. You can update your Bluetti firmware, configure your SolarX 4K and DC Hub, and even view the upcoming weather. For those that like deep dives, you can totally geek out on charts and graphs if that's your thing. The Bluetti app is intuitive, functional, and it just works.
So there you have it. The Apex 300 from Bluetti functions as an off-grid power supply, supplying all your off-grid needs, an uninterrupted power supply for your sensitive electronics, a whole home backup. In the event of a power loss, you can rest assured that all the critical systems in your house, all the appliances, your fridges, your freezers, your air conditioning, that kind of thing, can all be powered from the Bluetti Apex 300 during a power outage. If your coach batteries happen to go flat in your RV, you can switch everything over to the Bluetti Apex 300 and power everything in your RV to keep your camping experience fun and safe.
Guess what? Bluetti's Black Friday and Cyber Monday sale is live. You can get up to 70% off their best power stations, plus an extra 5% off with our code MYWILDHOME. It's their biggest sale of the year, and it's on now through December 2nd. Go check it out. The Bluetti Apex 300 power station really does tick all the boxes. The sheer scalability and thoughtful innovations in this package are second to none. Easiest 5 stars ever.